Oh, hey, Tom. Never gonna believe what happened yesterday.
What?
So, yesterday, I was literally just walking through the park. Nothing was really out of the ordinary. But then, just as I'm walking, man, Stephen Hawking's ghost comes out of the bushes and he says to me in his robotic voice, "Jack, you need to come with me." So I come with him, and then he gives me like these magic glasses, right? And I'm looking through these glasses, and suddenly I see aliens absolutely everywhere where I couldn't see them before.
Start talking to the aliens.
Could you imagine having six fingers?
No, I got a bit close to one. I mean, like, maybe got a bit too close.
Why do you need that many?
Traveled through time with the time glasses again and came back to the present. And yeah, that's pretty much all that happened. That's how I came over here.
You've certainly got a wild imagination.
I knew you'd never believe me.
That was an unquestionably made-up story.
Yeah, okay, maybe it wasn't true, but it could have been true.
There was not a smidge of realism in that barely cohesive ramble.
Yeah? Well, you're just bitter, because I actually believe you every time you tell me I won't believe something.
What?
You know, there have been so many times when you're about to tell me something incredible or amazing, and you always preface it with, "You'll never believe this," and I just believe you.
It's a saying.
The other day, you said, and I quote, "Oh, Jack, you'll never believe what I saw in the park last night."
Right.
And it was Mr. Fitzroy, our old English teacher, passed out drunk on a bench.
Yep. The difference is that actually happened.
Just admit it. I'm better than you at the believing game where you say, "Oh, you'll never believe this," and then the other person just believes it if they're good at the game like me.
That's not a proper game, you dingus.
Wow, you're such a sore loser. I'm a winner-winner chicken dinner.
So I lost this game because I didn't believe a story that wasn't true anyway.
Yeah, pretty much.
Great, yeah, good job, buddy. Great work.
I admitted when I lost at lawn bowls last week. So why can't you admit you're the loser this time?
Seriously, you're still upset about lawn bowls. It was just a casual afternoon game, man.
Not to me, it wasn't.
Why are you like this? Why do you always turn everything into some stupid competition?
Your tone of voice was really mean just then.
Look, I'm sorry. I got a bit frustrated.
I beat you, I beat you, I beat you again! And this time, I beat you. I beat you at the game where I pretend to be sad. And I fool you into thinking I'm sad.
None of these things are games. You're just making stuff up.
But I'm not really sad. I beat you.
I haven't lost any game.
I beat you.
I'm not a sore loser, man.
You can't win a single
game. I didn't lose any game. There was no game to lose. So I'm not a loser. You're the loser for thinking there is a game.
You can't do anything because I'm so much better. You fucking idiot. I'm so much better.
I'm not a sore loser. Well, this has been fun and all, but I've got to head off. I've got to go see my mate Stephen Hawking again. So, I guess this is goodbye for now. See ya.